Hello and welcome to 5-Star Repertoire channel. Today I'll be discussing about a new term that I've coined, which is cube description language. As you all must be knowing, like watching the previous video on this channel, that there is a language that I have created, which is called the Couard language. And the main aim of this language is it's composed of four blocks of letters which have meaning. So they have some kind of a meaning. And so my main aim was to get any four letters, and they should phonetically or some implied way they should have a meaning, and that was the main aim. And it is a lot of hard work because none of the languages work in this way except for like Sanskrit or maybe somewhat Chinese, but Chinese is again a very, very different language. So yeah, that was the main aim with the Couard language. But now recently I had joined an electronics company and I have to stare at HDL code every day. So what do I mean by HDL code? It's a hardware description language. So if you have some kind of a chip design, so suppose like this, some clock given here, and then some output that we want to get. So yeah, whenever we want to describe such kind of circuits, we can write a hardware description language, and it stands for HDL code. So I just thought I just should take this notion and apply it to not make a language out of letter quads, but make a description language. So what are the main thing features of cube description languages? First of all, they are mostly consisting of letter quads. So the language is modular and it's composing of letter quads, and whenever you want to recall a letter quad while you're executing a cube, there should be 100% you should be 100% sure about the first letter. So this can help you guess out, maybe sometimes 50% sure about the second, 25% sure about the third, 12.5% sure about the fourth. So your preparation in knowing all the letter quads, and then while memoing the letter quads and retrieving them, it should be some kind of this kind of proportion. And also this all letter quads, if you have suppose letter quad 1 and letter quad 2 and you want to connect them up, so mostly what I feel works best for me is to have batches of two letter quads and then connect them up. So this has a very big connector in between and this is a smaller connector. So this smaller connector is mostly ka or se in Hindi and Marathi, and then is similar to, so yeah. These are some kind of connectors, and this will be connected by some kind of visual loci sense. So yeah, this will be a very important connector which will prevent pausing. So yeah, that's this cube description language, and it's a 4-bit language, so A, B, C, D. So being in the digital sense, it's a 4-bit language, so bit 1, bit 2, bit 3, bit 4, and this range from A up to X. And if I have a 3x3 memo, then mostly, so letter quad 1 for edges, if I memo first, okay, let's go by the corners, what most people do. Letter quad 2 for corners. Let's hope the corners are resolved here in this, and it's not that hard of a scramble, and there's not a third letter quad. Then letter quad 3, letter quad 4, letter quad 5. So mostly there will be only 5 letter quads to memo the entire cube. And what you can do is have a weak connector here. And I'm talking about MBLD, because in 3BLD mostly you'll be doing audio of this whole 3 letter quads. But in MBLD, what you can do is to connect this up, then you can connect this up loosely, make a very giant image or two smaller image, so one or two image out of this. And then what you can do is you can reinforce it well, and this thing you can keep it as a loci. So yeah, this is how cube description language will work. And my main aim is to use this, if this is a 3x3, just drawing it like that. So my main aim is to encode the cube in U notation. So instead of scrambling, which we find in many timer apps, instead of doing the scrambling, like a trace from the UFUFR should be what describes the cube. So like a trace. So suppose my memo goes like A R A T C B O N B and then O A B G Q R S M and A F D I. So if my memo goes like this, so this thing should encode my cube and not the scramble. Suppose to get to this, I've done R2, L2, F, D prime, D2, F, D2, L. So this thing should not encode, but this thing should. And also to solve it, there should be like 5 5-style algs, and the average 5-style alg is around 12 mover. So a 12 move means 3 letter chords. So a total of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 times 3. So 15 letter chords will describe a solution, a 5 cycle solution. Generally, it may vary. So my main aim with cube description language is to have only 15 letter chords to have as a solution, and to have 5 letter chords to make up the scramble. So yeah, that's what cube description theory is. So yeah, like till now people just scramble the cube from the solid state holding green in front and white on top. And now with like lot of BLD tracing and like stuff happening in BLD, this can be an approach to encode up a cube and to work towards like representing cubes or memoing cubes and so on. So yeah, if you have any questions, please let me know in the comments. Thank you for watching.